No, it's so nice to, you know, finally get time away from your work.
I know. Honestly, you know, this day doesn't come every day of the year, you know, it's once a year, so I'm glad I'm spending it with you.
You're so sweet.
I just,
you know, wanted to tell you that.
Hold that for a second. Hey, how's it going, man? No, I'm not doing anything right now. I can make you there in 5 minutes. Yeah, I definitely remember that's happening today. Yeah, I know, she's cool. She's always chilling.
Where are you going?
No, she, I don't know. So I'll see you at the studio. Yep, bye. So, honey, I think we should just do leprechaun's day. You missed. My life be like.
I'm used to finding comfort in the zones, a closet bones I get used to. A mountain is Fontaine, spinning in monsoon and grinning is high octane. Explosive how I came, rolling down the hills cause life's a hassle. Encircled by my folly like a moat around the castle. Stay afloat, catch a second wind, thin is the air I breathe. Teary eyed nose running, wipe the snot on my sleeve.
Welcome to the Full Sail News. It's the holiday edition with Zachary Wright.
I made it on time today. All right. Today is our monthly holiday edition here at Full Sail. That means we are going to investigate, understand, and psychoanalyze every gosh darn holiday life for you to enjoy from the safety of your homes. I personally am here to take you along every step of the journey. So come with me.
Good evening, folks. I've got some breaking news regarding.
Hey. What's going on here, Jackson? I thought we said no news on the Valentine's Day special.
I'm just doing my job, Zach. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention.
You're just gonna do the news right now? You can't even let me warm up the crowd a little bit?
Talk to MIKEITH in the back. I was told to do breaking news for the show.
All right, keep a short, poopy head.
Thanks. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has reported an outbreak of drug-resistant bacteria in Florida and 11 other states linked to the use of eye drops. Researchers said open bottles of EsriCare artificial tears from multiple lots contained the VIMGESCRPA strain. These bottles were taken from infected and uninfected people in two different states. The CDC is advising individuals to take precautions and to seek medical attention if they experience any symptoms such as eye pain, redness, or changes in vision after using eye drops. Health officials are working to determine the source of the infection and prevent further spread of the bacteria.
Finally, Jackson, I get dementia just listening to you sometimes. I mean, time to get back to the show, all right, guys?
Yeah, I've got four more stories to go through.
No, not gonna happen.
What do you mean, not gonna happen?
All right, you can do one more, and that's because I'm being nice.
To meet the minimum time for commercials, I have to do at least two more stories. Okay? All right. Chick-fil-A has announced plans to test a new plant-based sandwich made with cauliflower as part of a pilot program in select locations.
That doesn't even sound like breaking news. Sounds like news I never asked about or care about. Anyone who reports is due to him, all right?
Just these two stories, and then I will leave. Thank you. The fast food chain is known for its chicken sandwiches, and this move marks a departure from its traditional menu offerings. The pilot program is a response to the growing demand for plant-based options and will allow Chick-fil-A to gauge customer interest and feedback. Starting Monday, the privately owned chain, which is the third largest in the U.S. by sales, has the menu item in Denver, Charleston, South Carolina, and the Greensboro Triad of North Carolina.
Don't the Chick-fil-A people hate the Mormons or something? I mean,
listen, I don't even write these stories. I'm just reading them. Let me read them.
You know, it used to just be me doing this.
Yeah, maybe if you got off the liquor, Zach, you might get your job back. How about that? Huh?
Right.
All right. A beloved camel at the Brevard Zoo in Florida has died unexpectedly. Sammy, who had been a resident of the zoo for over a decade, was a popular animal among visitors and the staff. The cause of death is currently unknown, and a necropsy will be performed to determine the cause. The zoo staff is mourning the loss of Sammy and offering their condolences to those who had the pleasure of visiting and interacting with him. The zoo has not yet acquired any, has not yet announced any plans to acquire another camel.
Fantastic. Get out of the show, Jackson. You're boring.
Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's Jake from State Farm. Sounds like a really good deal.
Jake from State Farm at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's Jake from State Farm.
What are you wearing, Jake from State Farm?
Khakis.
She sounds hideous.
Well, she's a guy, so...
Another reason more people stay with State Farm. Get to a better state.
Welcome back, folks. It's that time of the year again. Here is our annual date advisor with our very own Cupid Gabriel. Take it away, buddy.
Hi, everybody out there. I'm Cupid, if that is not made so egregiously obvious. And this Valentine's Day week, we went out to visit some of the best romantic hotspots. I am so, so excited for the love. Let's see where they went. Oh, but first, let me give you an arrow for your troubles. Bam! Happy Valentine's Day!
Today, we will be taking a look at the place that has become the new first date hotspot, Icon Park, where there are plenty of fun activities for a first date. Icon Park is home to a massive Ferris wheel where you can take your date and enjoy the stunning views from high above the park and see some incredible sights of Orlando. That's not all. You and your date can go on a thrill ride with the slingshot. This crazy piece of machinery will launch you hundreds of feet into the air. You and your date can also go on the Orlando Star Flyer, an impressive piece of machinery that will set you and your date on a swing and spin you around as it ascends into the sky. And not to worry if you get hungry, you can go and visit fun restaurants like the Tin Roof. There is plenty of live music and entertainment to be viewed as you eat. As the date ends, the two of you can stroll down Riley Parkway and enjoy the various concessions and activities there are to do, including, but not limited to, a wax museum, an aquarium, and the Maze of Mirrors, along with many other fun activities. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
Thanks, guys. All those restaurants sure made me hungry for questions. Questions of love. Maybe questions you might ask a love guru. And it's a good thing, because we have one right here in the studio for people just like me and you. Let's hear it for Sam and Shion. Ha ha! Yeah!
Ooh, I like their outfits today. Oh, I wasn't talking to you. Oh, this guy. Oh, a yoga? Yeah, yeah. Oh, well,
I'm here with Sam, who is a licensed marriage counselor here in Winter Park. And meanwhile, Shion is here, a self-proclaimed love guru, compares himself to Bob Marley. How are you guys doing today?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
Let's skip that question. I'm willing to bet that a lot of people come to you guys with questions of love.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's definitely in the job description, yeah. You?
A mí la gente me adora desde que me arrestaron. Yo golpeé a mi exmujer porque me enteré que se acostó con mi padre. Luego de eso, la gente me escribía a la prisión y así fue que me hice famoso. Quiero darle un saludito a mi hijo, Romberti. Te amo, hijo hermano. Eres importante para mí.
Hijo hermano.
Es que mi padre me embarazó a mi ex y tuve que criarlo y es mi hijo.
Oh.
Es mío. Y hermano.
Yeah, makes sense. Technically, what he says is that he got in jail, and on jail he became famous because the people was asking a lot of stuff about love and writing letters to him, so after that, he calls himself, like, a love guru.
Hmm. Caterpillars have to turn into butterflies someday, am I right? Latinos. Let's see what they have to tell us about love. We're going to ask some questions right from the audience right when we get back after this commercial.
Hey, big guy. Got a little holiday something for you. Tonight.
You might like this. Happy holidays.
It's the gift everyone wants to get. Give the holiday scratchers from the Georgia Lottery.
Oh, and we're back. Time to ask these two lovebirds love-related questions right from the audience. All right, so let's go to question number one. About a month ago, I made the mistake of flirting with someone else after me and my girlfriend had just had a fight. Long story short, she found out about it and forgave me, but it doesn't seem like she's really over it or trusts me anymore. What are some ways to rebuild the trust in a relationship?
Would you like to go first?
Para atrás no.
I guess...
Papito!
I guess he missed when he drops the soap.
Did you hear the question, sir?
Está en el programa.
Ya sé lo que él me dijo. Ella nunca se va a olvidar de eso. Ella te lo va a recalcar en la cara cada vez que te vea, te va a estar tirando trapos al medio y te la va a pegar con tus amigos. Ah. Yo tengo un remedio para ti muy importante. Recomiendo que me llames después del programa.
What he says is that she's toxic and for the next 10 years or how long your relation get, she's gonna bring up stuff like for arguments.
So it's one of those people who's gonna rehash the past over and over, huh? Maybe just dump her.
That's one way to do it. First of all, I'm very sorry that happened to you. And you know, these things take time, especially after, you know, this person has trusted you and now they can't anymore because of something you did. You should go to your partner about your concerns and build boundaries. That way you could build that trust again.
Sounds like a lot of feelings. Question number two says, it feels like no matter what I do, I'm still single. I don't know what I'm doing wrong, but I've been single for years now, and it just seems like no one wants me. How can I meet someone?
Well, I find that a lot of the time when I'm talking to these kinds of people, they're constantly searching and, you know, in places just actively trying to search for love and find love. And sometimes maybe that one pottery class opens a whole new door of new people that you never met before. So, you know, let it happen naturally and you'll find love in the least, in places you least expect it.
Huh, pottery.
Amiga, no seas tan patética. Nadie va a querer estar con una perdedora como tú. Tienes que hacer algo para recoger tu autoestima, aunque sea con una pala. Tengo un remedio para ti. Vas a coger una papaya, le harás un corte, vas a poner una foto de tu crush y la pondrás en un envase en el que orinarás todas las mañanas. A los 13 días, tu crush tocará la puerta de tu casa y adivina qué, te va a pedir esa papaya.
Papaya.
Se la va a comer. Cuando empieza a comérsela, los fluidos le van a bajar así por el pecho. Ya tú vas a saber que ese macho es tuyo completo. Te vas a acordar de mí.
Huh. Wow. Honestly, you just sound beautiful listening. That was a lot of Spanish, sheesh. Huh. If I learned anything in the last segment, it was that love has winners and losers. It almost seems sometimes like love is a mindless pastime that only the strongest can conquer. Are you hot or are you not? This is a question that our very own reporter Love Machine asked this last week to students around Full Sail. Let's see what they had to say.
I'm the Love Machine. I'm here asking some pressing questions to Full Sail students. Let's go and find out what's going on. Box of chocolates, flowers. the classics. You know, I actually gotta go with flowers.
Wrong.
Excuse me, Full Sail, this is the Love Machine. Do you love the Love Machine?
I don't even know what that is.
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
Do you love the Love Machine? What? Do you love the Love Machine?
No.
What is the best love song for Valentine's Day?
The best love song for Valentine's Day. Can I curse? Pussy Monster by Lil Wayne.
Hot or not, right now. Smash.
Smash?
We're getting the right questions here. We're the right people. Okay, let's keep going.
Hot or not?
I'm a pass.
Pass?
Pass, I'm sorry.
Why?
I'm into cars.
I'm in love with my car.
Same question.
I think that's a good picture of him, but I've seen him look. So,
gotcha.
So I'll say, judging by this picture, that's a good shot of him.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, let's get on with the news. Hi, excuse me. We're a Full Sail one. Could you... Hot or not?
Wait.
See my glasses?
Where are we?
Wait, got some. Excuse me. Could you play Hot or Not? Wait. Wait a minute.
Wow. How the world circles around, I guess. That's just the minor power of love.
Is this hot?
Yes.
Yes. See,
okay, have a good one.
Thank you very much. Do you have a girlfriend?
No.
Perfect. Use this. This is the chick. That's how you do it, bro.
I don't know what to say. Free love is kind of destroying love right now, especially because so many people seeming to be going single for this Valentine's Day. Huh? How about that, huh? Well, that's the very blasphemous thought of Valentine's Day, you cretins and you frickin' weirdos who think that love does not matter. Love does matter! I will show you. Shoot love right into your frickin' face if I have to. Because that's my job. So don't you dare think about that shit around me.
Yeah, man, I'm attracted to this table. What a nice looking table. Nice table. Okay, well, this is the Love Machine. Here at Full Sail. Back to you in the studio.
Wow. Love Machine, you are getting frisky with that table. I, too, can't help myself around some pieces of furniture, to be honest, but... Now, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to prepare yourselves for the Latino god of music and dance himself, Rodriguez. Take it away.
Quiero contarle a mi hermano un pedacito de la historia negra, de la historia nuestra, caballero. Y dice así.
Bienvenidos. Yo soy Christian Culkin Rodriguez, el salsero de noche. Today, I'm going to teach you how to salsa, the language of love, with your partner today. Today I have my partner, the beautiful cat, mi hermana. Watch very closely, DJ.
En los años 1600, cuando el tirano mandó, de Cartagena, aquella historia vivió.
Listen very closely. I will teach you how to do this dance in three very easy steps. Make sure you watch the feet. Now you have your left foot first. You get a very beautiful partner and you go one, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. The same with the back leg. You go one, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Now the hardest part of salsa is adding the salsa. You must add the love to your dance. Ready? You watch very closely now. DJ! Salsa.
Holy guacamole, that was picante! Ah, this next segment is so spicy, though, it'll make your eyes water. It's that time of the year, folks. Hit it!
Oh, I love that. My fellow Americans, it is I, Barack Obama. And today, Barry O's about to whip up some...
Shut up. No one cares. I'm Donald Trump, and today we are cooking fantastic meals. You could say the best meals for our wives. Only the best.
We've set aside our differences for the sake of love.
Yes, we did.
And the country to cook the most romantic dish.
That's right. What we're cooking today is going to be mucho delicioso with my bro, Barry O, here.
So, tell me, Trump, what are you cooking for the peoples today?
Freedom. It's going to be served with a Capitol building. You want to know what the secret is? Love. Love for this country and the amazing people and laws that are in it.
And our wives.
Right. Them too.
Love you, Michelle. speaking of that, how's your wife?
She's doing great. She actually spoke English the other day. Something along the lines of, I hate you.
You know this is live, right?
Live or not, I'm really hungry and my wife loves me. So let's get our crock pot in, Barack.
Your words continue to leave me befuddled.
That's great. And right on, man. Right on.
All politics aside, those two seem to be having a real good time. Maybe too good. Let's see what romantic decadence they prepared for us today.
Identity Trump, and I approve of this song.
Yeah, well, you approve of this. Well, welcome back, fellow Americans. It's time to taste our most delicious presidential dishes.
Get ready, folks. You might want to be sitting down for this. Barack, my homie, and I made sure these exquisite dishes tasted absolutely delicioso to the max. Maybe my wife won't hate me after this.
Maybe. Now, let me be clear. These dishes we put together are what my daughters would call a bussin'. Really bussin'. For real.
Anja, my friend. Anja. Now, what exactly did you cook for us today?
Today, I give to you, fine fellow Americans, a marvelous bowl of Kraft mac and cheese. Just mix this around. Yeah.
Why does it sound like the sound my wife was making last night?
Come again?
Ramen.
Yeah, ramen.
That is what I made today. I thought, you know, what is better than garbage that the American people love to put in their bodies?
You know, I never thought I'd say this, but it's a really beautiful thought, Trump.
Really? You think so?
Yeah.
I spent all 2 minutes figuring that out.
This is the longest time you spent with anything.
I know.
To be honest, I didn't know what to expect from the show today. I really thought you were going to be more like the Cheeto to my Dorito. But really, you're the PB to my J.
Why can't we be both? You want to get out of here?
Absolutely.
All right, let's go get Melania.
God bless America. Michelle. I love you, Michelle. Don't think anything of this. It's completely normal. Just
this is what politicians do all the time.
Yeah, it's normal.
That's exactly what's tragically normal. You're
Ooh-wee. That was more like Brokeback White House than any cooking show I've ever seen. And now, ladies and gentlemen, but mostly the ladies, be prepared to be frank with Frank.
Hello, everyone. I'm Colin Chase, and this is a segment we like to call To Be Frank with Frank, and I'm here with Frank.
Hello, I'm Frank.
All right, we're going to ask a couple questions, and my first one for you is going to be, who pays on the first date?
You know, that's one of those age-old questions. Really, some people say it's whoever asked. Some people say it's the man, the woman, and or other, wherever you land.
We don't
it's
know.
It's up to you guys. It's whoever's broke, who's got the money, who asked. Go for it.
If you're broke, you're broke.
People's broke these days.
Yeah. Next question, what is it, do you think, that people are looking for in an ideal partner?
Man, it's hard to say what people are looking for, what they're into, what they like. You know, I always say my wife was the smartest person I've ever met that was dumb enough to marry me. So find someone who's smart, but just enough.
Yeah, I mean, my wife didn't even like me. She still married me.
I get that.
And she left me.
That tracks.
Anyways, we can move on from that.
Yeah, sorry.
How long into a relationship do you think that it's okay to fart around one another?
Oh, sooner the better. Get it out of the way. It's gonna happen. It's natural. Plan like a gassy food for like date 4 or 5. Let it rip. You know, the first time my wife fired back on me, I knew she was a keeper.
Yeah. I mean, my wife couldn't even do that. I'm still here.
I can't do that.
It's okay. Anyways, when would it be necessary to meet their parents?
No. Third, fourth grandkid, maybe when you need a babysitter. But before that, no. Every time my in-laws come over, there's something going on, and I'm just like, oh, hi, 15 people in my house that I didn't invite. They're good, great people, though. I love you guys. But stay home. Fourth or fifth kid, maybe.
Agreeable. And my final question for you, Frank, to be frank.
I'll be frank, yeah.
Do you believe in true love?
Oh, of course, yes. I mean, without true love, what is all this for? You know, all the dog and pony race, everything we're trying to do. Without true love, all this is just figure skating.
Indeed. I wish I felt that way. And anyways, that was To Be Frank with Frank, everyone. Thank you for watching.
And that, everyone, was To Be Frank with Frank. Wasn't that toxic? Just another day in America, as I always say. In the conclusion of this show, love, as much as we try to define it, is both complicated and confusing. For some of you watching, you might still have hope for the future, and I think there's some optimism in that. Actually, squander that, because I swear to you, love is dead. I listen to Nickelback, I would know, and I hope it was worth it, everyone! Worth your little woody-doody show! Quite frankly, you can all have a terrible night, and look what I got dumped over this Hobby Lobby-looking show. Every holiday we have to do this. Where's my Christmas? Where's my Easter? Really? When do I get a break? I quit!
Well, that's Full Sail News, the holiday edition. Hope you enjoyed it.